today, on behalf of all of the freshmen senators who were elected on the Democratic side, plus Senator Sanders, who caucuses with us, even though he's an independent, to announce we are introducing a bill that will create a commission on wartime contracting. Senator McCaskill and I have taken the lead on this for this group of people because we both are on the Armed Services Committee. We are expressing the views and the intentions of all of the people who were elected on this side of the aisle last fall. Government accountability was a major issue in all of our campaigns, and there's probably no area in recent history that has a greater need for government accountability than the expenditures that have gone into Iraq and Afghanistan. The GAO did a report that said that between 2003 and 2006 in Iraq alone, $300 billion were allocated toward reconstruction programs and those sorts of things in Iraq and Afghanistan. And there's been remarkable little accountability. We've seen the Special Inspector General have good accountability in their initial years of activity, particularly on the State Department side, but there's been very little on the Department of Defense side. And so I, bringing a background from the Defense Department, I had 4 years on a Defense Resources Board where we were looking at contracts and this sort of thing, and Senator McCaskill, with her background as a state Auditor General, and Auditor General? How do we say
it? State Auditor.
Auditor. State Auditor, and Senator Casey is State Auditor General in Pennsylvania. We have a real strong focus on this area. This commission is going to do three things. It's going to look retroactively at the contracts that have been let to try to get accountability, and we would like to see financial accountability in those areas where there has been fraud, waste, and abuse. We'd like to help the taxpayers of this country get their money back, and we'd also like to see legal accountability. This commission is empowered to recommend to the Justice Department criminal actions. This is in consonance with what has been going on already with the organization that they call SIGR. We're not trying to create a new bureaucracy here. We're going to use the Special Inspector General for Iraq Reconstruction, where our idea is to broaden its powers rather than create a new structure. We're not going to try to create something that's going on for the next 10 or 15 years like so many bureaucracies do. This is a sunsetted program. It's 2 years. The first report will come to us after 1 year, but at any time that this commission identifies items that need to be addressed, they can make a report. So in other words, there's a mandatory report after 1 year, but at any time that they see that there should be a report, they are empowered to do that. This is not a group of senators. We are tremendously respectful of the work that has come before us, particularly people like Senator Dorgan, who attempted to do this last year on the Senate side. But what we're trying to do is to get a group of experts that are going to go into this full-time, bipartisan experts who will then report to the Congress rather than having congressional committees do it themselves. I am enormously hopeful that this will put the kind of accountability that we need to see in all these programs over there. As a couple of just really quick points of fact, the SIGR, when they first went into place in 2005, reported that out of the $32 billion in Iraq reconstruction programs from the State Department, there were $9 billion that could not be accounted for. And I think we all deserve better than that. There are a lot of good companies that are working over there. They got nothing to worry about. But the companies that have been inefficient, wasteful, or conducted fraudulent behavior, we want to get some accountability for that. I've tried on the Foreign Relations Committee and the Armed Services Committee to get some data about where these contracts have gone, both on the State Department side and the Armed Services side. And to this point, and this actually began in February, we still have not been able to get the kind of data where we can measure where these programs have taken place, what their success has been, and what the accountability has been. So this is, I believe, a very necessary and essential step for us to put the right kind of accountability into the government.